join us as final preparations are underway for the 2020 Cork of the Broads race, raising money for the care workers charity in this extraordinary year of lockdown. All over the world, regattas have had to be cancelled, including this weekend on the Broads, the Thurn Mouth Open Regatta. Today would normally be the Cock of the Broads race day, a race to determine the fastest boat and crew on the Broads. In the Cock, the best take on the rest. Graphic clearly shows the prestigious Cock of the Broads trophy is not only bigger and shinier than the Cork trophy, but also considerably less silly. Today's event is a Poosticks race. Numbered corks representing boats will be launched from this bridge. Hopefully, at least one will make it to the finishing line and claim the Cork of the Broads trophy. There's a real carnival feel about today. Here's the Thurn Dyke Band. They're playing a medley of particular favourites of mine. And there's a good turnout on the bank to watch. One of the many pluses of the lockdown has been the number of old friends rediscovered in the nation's attics. What a perfect way to spend your day in the sun, especially if you've been stuffed in a box in the loft for the last 50 years. This event, which incidentally also replaces the Tokyo Olympics, has attracted entries from far beyond the Broads. Tall ships, long ships, a camper van, and even a hunter jet are among those included, and sailing clubs from all over are represented, all boosting the total raised for care workers so far to just under £3,000. All eyes are on the river. But the main concern now, we understand, is the strength of the crosswind. This could spell disaster. Wind is often the bane of a poo event. Pooh and Piglet are usually credited as the inventors of poo sticks, but Eeyore is clearly worried that the whole thing is going tits up, and they ought to get back to the loft before they get the blame. Back at Race HQ, the corks are being marshalled ready for the start. Mickey's looking rattled as he checks to see no corks are spilled and that the container that'll carry the corks to the bridge is covered decorously. The launching of any contents from a chamber pot into the river should always be discreet. Upon the bridge, all is set. So it's over to you, Mr. Starter.
No gun! Fire!
And over we go for the start of the 2020 Extraordinary Cork of the Broads race. The splashdown, like any start, is critical. This start seems to be entirely clean. No sign of the sort of cork-on-cork action that might raise a protest. Some of the fleet are making progress, but what's this? A contingent seemed to be heading straight for the boat shed. A safe move in this wind. Next stop, the bar, methinks. There's certainly plenty for the crowd to enjoy here. but there's trouble out on the water. These chaps have clearly been seized by the giant hand, as coarse yachtsmen say, and rammed themselves firmly in the reeds. Number six is a Gairloch One design from Scotland. An early bar for them. Fortunately for the retirees, the East Anglian Cruising Club have got their party tent rigged as usual. Here, between races, or if retiring, crews can avail themselves of a large range of refreshments from the friendly food counter or the well-stocked bar. Not for nothing is EAC known as a drinking club with a sailing problem. Oh, thank you very much. Yes, don't mind if I do. Cheers. Out on the water, those remaining in the fleet are becoming quite strung out, except for those who are stuck together. The gentle stream has tended to slow proceedings somewhat and brought some to a stop. This break from the excitement gives us a chance to explore the history of Poosticks, which is now thought to be much older than A.A. Milne's reference in The House at Pooh Corner in 1928. Professor Harry Brubaker of the Institute of Studies has recently discovered that early man, who enjoyed a diet rich in nuts, berries and beans, would often, in the early morning, sit together on a convenient branch overhanging a river. There they launched their logs and watched them drift downstream. Today, of course, modern sanitation has somewhat removed the competition element from such activity, but somehow the name Poosticks stuck. The combination of sun, beer, and sod all happening on the water has taken its toll on the crowd. Mexican Pete is perhaps dreaming of the Alamo, while Muffin the Mule is looking much more relaxed now people have discovered Smirnoff. Milo has decided to emigrate. Teenage Doll, who was dressing up before Barbie was born, has come out in the lockdown outfit of choice, her pyjamas. But what's this on the water? Paddle boarders. Every year, cock of the broad sailors have to deal with the hazard of novice hire boaters. Luckily, you can't sink a cork, even with a paddle. Downstream, there's some movement. Corks are suddenly in striking distance of the finishing line. But who's in the lead? The crowd's on its feet. This has really brought them to life. It's going to be close, very close indeed, and it's hard to see who's out in front. There's a knot of corks ahead of the rest. We're going to need a photo finish. But there is a clear leader. And yes, we have a winner. Number 1000, representing Lady Mary, skipper Neil Duffield. Even with this satellite image, it's impossible to separate the runners-up, but amongst them are E236, Northerner, 24, Pippa, YS1, Yellow Sail, UT1, Daneslayer, a Saxon longship, TF1, Theo's floater, and 282, Sandpiper. So Lady Mary is the winner of this very special and hopefully never-to-be-repeated Cork of the Broads, a fun fundraiser in aid of the Care Workers charity. Donations can still be made via the Cork of the Broads Just Giving page, so if you've enjoyed our coverage, even as a repeat, please continue to give generously. That brings to a close our live Norfolk broadcast from this little-known canal, a very long way from all Britain's other canals. So from me, Alan Titchmarsh, on the banks of this far canal, until the next time, goodbye, good health, and as Brucey might have said, keep sailing.
It's amazing how much memory this thing's got.
Which is more than can be said for us.
Well, all the corks are safely gathered in.